This morning, we're hearing more about the deadly salon shooting in Casselberry from the witnesses themselves.
Bradford Belmont killed three women and gravely wounded his ex-girlfriend 1 week ago today. Now, WESH 2 has obtained police interviews, and WESH 2's Kara Moore is live in Casselberry where all this happened. And Kara, I understand that there's going to be an event there later on today.
Yeah, later this morning, in fact, Meredith, at 11 o'clock, there will be a prayer vigil here at this Casselberry salon on the day one of the victims, the salon co-owner, in fact, was supposed to go to court for protection against the shooter. We're also now hearing police interviews with witnesses who were inside the salon when Bradford Bonnet opened fire, killing three women and critically injuring his ex-girlfriend. One woman described Bonnet's every move.
I laid there. I could see the gun pointed at Marie, and he shot her a first time and then shot her a second time.
She went on to say that after shooting the women, Bonnet held a gun to his head but did not shoot. We know instead Bonnet left and later killed himself inside a home in Winter Park. We've talked a lot recently about a string of deadly domestic violence shootings here in Central Florida, and tonight the Florida Civil Rights Association will be holding a town hall meeting with local law enforcement in observance of Domestic Violence Awareness Month to talk about the recent violent events like this one in our area. That meeting is at 6 o'clock tonight at Southside Church of Christ in Orlando. Live in Casselberry, Seminole County, Kara Moore, WESH 2 News.